Happy National Masturbation Month. As usual, I'm not making this up. In recognition of this auspicious occasion, I did a bit of research on the World Wide Web. When I searched masturbation, I got 5,278,171 websites. Wow. When I searched good, clean, fun, I got 2,018 sites. And the second one said, impregnate a camel. It's good, clean, fun. I'm not making this up either. Today, I'd like to address the issue of female masturbation. How come we don't have clever, humorous names for girls bringing themselves to orgasm? It's not like it's uncommon. Girls may start later, but they usually make up for lost time once they've figured out their plumbing. Guys have spanking the monkey, jerking off, beating your meat, choking the chicken, buffing the bishop, polishing the knob, jerking your gherkin, and of course, dating five-fingered Mary. Girls have nothing. To end this unfortunate void, I set my girlfriends in action and they came through for me. My personal favorite is twanging the twat. Playing in the grass is a bit too poetic, and fondling the furrow seems only appropriate in rural settings. Twisting the love knob sounds like it hurts, and rubbing the stub is a bit too prosaic. Diddle dancing seems to have that female appeal while taking away the need to say it in a hushed whisper. Let your fingers do the walking is kind of empowering. Whatever you call it, girls, just remember, everybody's doing it, even if they don't say it out loud. Live in an auto-copulatory way from the home of the future. It's the Greg Sterlace Show, starring Greg Sterlace, the man who helped pass the bill to make masturbation mandatory in these United States of America.
Hello, testing, testing. Is this goddamn thing on?
I think it's working.
Rick, can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Can you hear me, buddy?
Absolutely.
I want this to be the best show ever, because the first one the rest of our lives, buddy!
Yay!
It's only fitting that you're back.
Why?
Because you've been such an important part of the show over the years with all your great, witty, zany comments and your antics and your belligerence.
Yeah. Remember when you and Rick used to argue?
Yeah,
well,
those
all
days
the time
were
alright.
I used to argue with Gwen too. That's over with.
We're done arguing.
I have a
no
whole
more.
New.
It used to be when I came on, we would have something to talk about, but we never do.
Then it faded out. There was nothing to talk about after that. Because I remember summer 95, yeah. It was the OJ trial.
That was great.
So the whole damn half hour was talking about the OJ
that
trial.
Was great.
And then after that, every time you came out,
it was UFOs.
UFOs.
Oh, yeah.
It was UFOs.
Right. And now we did that.
Now the last thing we did was that comically
circle.
Incorrect, and
yeah,
that tanked really.
It was not comically.
I was experimenting, though. Yeah. I tried to experiment, and yeah, it sucked. It sucked.
It didn't work.
It blew.
Yeah. It didn't work.
It blowed.
And I think I was on with Bruce Adams.
Oh, yeah, you were on with Bruce Adams.
Bruce Adams.
I remember that.
Okay, and yeah, you're right. I mean, the Bruce Adams was good.
Yeah, that was fun.
Why are we taking this trip down memory lane? It's because of all the good times we had together. Let's look back. Let's look at that. I'm thinking the summers are always such a special time here. This is my sixth summer here, and you've always been a special part of it. Your beautiful face.
Thank you.
Your shining eyes.
And I might actually be leaving.
Why don't you ever shave, though?
I never shave because I don't think about it.
Is that as much as you can grow? You can't get a real beard going, right?
No, I got a real
beard. Oh, go ahead. Walk, Gwen.
No, I don't like to shave either.
There you go.
So is that why you always have that mustache, then?
Yeah.
That would go more. Now, here's a conspiracy thing for you, Rick. No, I'm not going to get into that. Anyways.
Go ahead.
I'm a man.
I'm not going to get into that. No, sorry. I just feel so. I feel like. See, what happened was these two guests were supposed to be on tonight, right? And they canceled out on me. And then Kevin Hosey saved the day, right? He's coming out later. The greatest person ever who ever existed in Buffalo, New York, Kevin Hosey.
And he got stung by a bee.
He got stung by a bee.
And he burned himself on the iron, and he still came.
He got burned by an iron. He got stung by a bee.
And he's our hero.
He's a man. Let's get a shot of him.
He comes to save the day.
Woo-hoo!
Kevin!
Speech! I'll do a speech later.
Later.
No, I gotta leave now after that.
No, I'm thinking about Rick. I'm thinking about.
You saved a day.
Check
too.
This out. I mean, I'm thinking about running for president in the year 2000, right?
Yeah.
Now, at first, I thought about having my mentally ill brother be my vice president. But now I'm thinking it's you, Rick.
No.
You'd be a great vice president, man.
Gwen, we need a woman vice president. I'll be like Secretary of State.
You can't have chicks in the White House.
I'll be director of the CIA. That's what I want.
You want to run the CIA?
I want to run the CIA.
You can run the CIA.
So Gwen would be the vice president.
Vice president, Gwen.
That way, if you get on my nerves, I can arrange for you to have...
I have less skeletons in my closet than Hillary Clinton, I guarantee.
And what do you want to... How are you going to shake the CIA up if you ever get in there? Well, how would you shake it up? Would you have, like, a whole... You'd get all new people, right?
Yeah.
Who you can trust.
Yeah.
Because if you go in there now and you just take over, none of those people are going to trust. They're not going to trust you. You can't trust them. Am I right?
Right.
So I
think I'll command respect from the force of my personality.
I have an idea.
Shave for the job, right?
Yeah.
And you're going
to... Put out time.
What do you got in the hair there? Moose? You got moose
crusty
in the hair?
Stuff. Crusty stuff.
Crusty
spray.
Stuff.
Yeah, the
crusty stuff. Is that like from like The Simpsons?
Yeah.
So they have crusty like hair product.
Yeah, that's right.
I don't know. It's part of this guy's GQ. Look at him. He's just like
crusty stuff.
You remind me of like Richard Gere.
Thank you.
I can see you having sex with Cindy Crawford on a table or with gerbils even. I can see you having sex with gerbils. You know what? Wait a minute. Am I fucked up? Am I really punched up? I don't know, like a third, three-fourths of the way or something. Am I really?
What color are you?
I guess I'm probably punched up. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm just so excited. So anyways, I'm going to be president. And, oh, that's great. Thanks. I'm going to be president.
What I'm going to do is I'm going to cut taxes.
I'm going to be vice president.
And Gwen will be vice president.
Because really, vice presidents don't have to do anything.
They don't do anything. They don't
darker,
do shit.
Darker,
that's the job I want, vice president.
Just like in a show. You're sitting there.
Right.
You know,
all I have to do is look good. That's my whole job.
And you don't even do that anymore.
What do you mean?
Rick, don't you think that Gwen can, you know, take care of herself to look good? Because look at this. I mean, look
she
at
looks
this.
Fine.
Doesn't she look kind of like bedraggled or like she just got out of bed or something?
No.
Oh.
No, it's the ruffled look.
Right, exactly.
It's the new
she looks
ruffled
charmingly
look.
Disheveled.
Yes, it's like I'm just a little scattered the way.
What author would you most like to kill?
Jeff Simon.
Jeff Simon?
That was
wow.
easy. That was too
I'm
easy.
Sorry. I,
that was
I said an author.
Author.
Is he an author? Oh, he's a
you
writer.
You got me there. No, you
yeah,
got me there.
Yeah, because you know words are important, Rick.
Yeah.
The meaning. So,
do you want
to kill Jeff Simon?
No.
Kill him?
Like
but
Jeff
he's my
okay.
hero, though. Why would you want to kill Jeff Simon?
Why wouldn't I?
Oh, okay. What author would you want to kill?
What author would I want? You mean like what? Book author? Like literary? Like novels? Like what?
Like something
I don't
want to
kill anybody.
Or fiction or cookbooks. I like to kill, you know.
Oh, well,
Martha
nonfiction.
Stewart.
Martha Stewart.
I like to kill Martha Stewart.
I'm not so annoyed by her. How about Laura? No, I got one.
Laura.
What media figures would you like to kill?
What media figures would you like to kill?
I would like to take out most talk show radio hosts in Buffalo. We could start with
Clip Smith. Don't like the Clipper?
Don't like the Clipper.
You don't like his little puns?
Oh, I hate his puns.
And you like to kill John Otto?
Puns are
no,
fun.
Otto's suffering enough just being alive, I think. So
the bulldog? You want to kill the bulldog?
I don't listen to the bulldog. The coach?
Oh, the coach? The coach is good.
Do you like
Why won't the coach come on our show? That's what I want to know.
Yeah, the coach said that he can't come on our show because you're affiliated with it.
How about what's the guy in the morning?
Tom Bowerly?
No.
Breakfast with Bowerly?
I thought it was Bob Bowerly.
No, it's Tom Bowerly.
Did you hear this
Bowerly.
Thing they're going to have this
like
weekend?
Him.
They have a thing called Mix and Match, or it's like some kind of computer dating thing.
Yeah.
And he's going to be the master of ceremonies.
Yeah, so they used to have Desperate and Dateless.
Yeah,
the same
you pay $25 to $30 to get into this thing. They're
going
to computer match you at the thing. Like, so
I hope I get a chick.
They're going to do it on the spot.
I get a chick.
Is that for both sexual, heterosexual?
Apparently hetero.
Only
yeah.
hetero.
Yeah.
Well, I'll get a chick.
And then he actually said today, if you put down on your interest that it's Star Trek, don't bother coming, stay in your mother's basement. I guess, God forbid, any loser should show up at this thing.
I thought the whole thing was...
I like Star Trek.
Right?
Are you
Isn't
going?
That why
are
you go?
Nah, you've got to be entering. You're a loser.
No, nah, anytime right? Tom Bowerly gets near me, nah.
Gwen.
I'm entering.
Rick's
oh, but
you're
I
not a loser.
I have a boyfriend.
Check this out. I talked to Gwen recently.
Yeah.
Right here. And she said, she's never got hit on in her life by any guys. Do you believe that crap?
What really?
What a lie. It's a lie. Anyways.
No, it's not really a lie. Except for that guy that just called and asked me if I was on heroin.
Courtney, you
I
look like what's
kind
her name?
Like courting thing.
Courtney
say.
Love.
I
you mean, look like Courtney Love.
I guess that
doesn't she?
Kind of.
Do a little song for
hitting
us now.
On me. Do a little song for you.
Your band's called Hole, right?
No.
Hole. Yeah, I don't know why you want to kill. I'd rather kill some of the national media figures.
Yeah, them
like
too.
Like Larry King, for instance. Mm. That guy's got to go.
My mother loves Larry King.
Geraldo Rivera.
Geraldo Rivera's got to go.
I like Geraldo.
Anybody on Fox News.
Jay Leno.
Got to go.
He's got to go.
Jay Leno?
Jay Leno must die.
Why do you want to kill anybody?
And of
anybody?
Course, the person I most want to kill in life is Don Henley.
Why?
Why? Yeah, that's a weird
why?
Guy. Don Henley. Just look at him.
Why?
You want to vomit.
Isn't that a singer?
Well, see, if you put me in charge of the CIA, I can arrange all these things.
Okay. Thank you, buddy. Thank you very much. Thank you. Love well, America. Too. World domination.
I just
world
want
domination.
To say I
world
don't want to kill
world
anybody.
World domination.
World domination. World domination.
I don't think Clip. That killing is good.
Shut up, Gwen.
It's bad.
We're back with the greatest person in history, Kevin J. Hosey.
Hello,
who's saving the night tonight. He's the warmest, most sensitive artist I know. We were two people copped out on us, Gwen, let me guess, and Kevin saved the day at the last second.
Yeah. So,
Kevin!
Yay! Yay!
He's a giant
yay,
among men!
Yay! Yay!
Now, Kevin, back in 97, when Bad Ron and I played the Star Bar, you said in your nightlife account that we were the most fantastic thing you ever saw. We're
no, he astounded. Didn't say that.
He said astounding.
He said astounding.
Startling. A startling
original,
revelation.
Original. He said original.
Anyways, be quiet. Startling revelation.
I remember.
And he said
original.
We shocked and stunned the audience. Shocked and stunned them. And now I'm going to show
I like that Liverpudlian little touch there.
That was after Brian Epstein died that I said that. Remember after Brian Epstein died, they asked John Lennon. He said, we're shocked, we're stunned. Oh, that was in the Ruddles. We're shocked, we're stunned, we're stunned, we're shocked. Anyways,
we're
going to show this clip that Ron and I did in 99. For your rock critic evaluation, and this thing is nowhere as good as the startling.
it might be startling though.
Okay,
it is a
roll
startling,
that clip.
But it's not a
Richard Wicca Esquire.
It's not quite simple. There we are.
Done.
That's Greg.
You.
That's me right there.
Yeah. See my head?
Yeah, but I knew it was you. There's not that cheesy pseudo. Fu Manchu.
He's like, that's me, Greg.
Glad I'm on. Hi, guys.
Hi, fans. I don't see Kevin anymore.
There he is. Look at he's looking all
see how
serious.
Emotional I am?
He's like trying to seduce.
Jeez,
I'm seducing the audience here.
He's emoting.
He's like,
emoting.
Or is it emodium?
Emodium.
You're so. Oh, there's
me closing eyes. That's beautiful.
Greg, who are you?
He's going for it, folks.
What I'm saying in your it's in your eyes.
It's almost like he's trying to seduce.
Uncomplicated.
You think it's over now?
He looks like Dave Stewart on Quaaludes.
This is only the beginning. The beginning. You think it's over now, but this is only.
The beginning.
See, it's the beginning, Kevin. See, we're starting anew tonight.
Woo!
First show of the rest of our life.
Way to go, Bad Ryan! Yeah!
And shocked.
And shocked.
I
shocked and
haven't heard stuff like that in a while.
I don't want to.
You know what? That would be perfect for Hall Walls, Greg. That artsy, you know, hip crowd.
So you're saying go for the artsy, fartsy, intellectual crowd. Is that what you're saying?
Well, when you had the black on, that added a nice
background.
Yeah, I like that, man.
Now, what is that?
That's an outtake from Sergeant Pepper, I believe.
But on a letter grade, what would you give that, like for between A and F?
I might have to separate it.
Okay.
The singing was like a B+ or so.
Of course. That was awesome stuff.
The musical accompaniment was kind of C-.
Oh, my God. You're putting Bad Ronald down?
Let's How get about him on, the audience the phone participation?
Right now. Can we call him on the phone right now and get him in here? What about the emotion I had?
The closing of the eyes, the acting.
Because that's what I'm into. Acting.
See, this time you weren't
like
pushing.
Bitch here. I mean, Gwen. I mean, bitch. Sorry. No, Gwen. Sorry. Go ahead.
Bitch.
What'd you say?
Jeez.
Sorry. Back to you.
You had a different way of finding your emotion. It wasn't the you've done with your vocals. Your vocals before you.
Vocals.
I'm doing my own.
No, he's developing his emotion.
I like to think of myself as Jim Morrison.
He's becoming an emotional poet.
You know, when
singer.
I'm singing, I think to myself, I am
Sterling
Jim Morrison.
Maybe.
Rather than, he doesn't want to be a punky screamer anymore. He wants to sing.
Story Morrison would be bad either. I'm using my voice as a guitar.
He's using his voice as an instrument now.
And he's dead,
novel.
Too. They're both dead. Think about that. Story Morrison dead and Jim Morrison dead. What's the odds of that happening, you know?
It's not a coincidence.
That's what I'm saying. It's not a coincidence. So anyways, Kevin, our esteemed colleague. Oh, let's, first of all, you guys show you got injured here.
He got injured.
Bit you,
before
right?
and when I got here. Yes, I was sitting in the green room out there.
Right.
Yes.
Sitting in the green
and
room.
And there's something crawling up my leg, and I'm usually don't get that. And
no,
here, I'll help, Kevin.
Believe me, I don't get that. So I grabbed my pants. Ouch. There's something small and hard in it. I thought it was part of my Jillian from lunch.
I thought it was part of your package.
I went
outside. Small and hard.
It wouldn't have been small.
Oh, no.
Sorry.
Good point. I forgot.
And I would have taken
you're a big man.
It might have taken both hands, Greg.
So no.
I went outside, and a dead bee falls out of my pants, which really does great for the self-esteem, for one thing.
Well, you killed a bee before you came on.
And there was redness, there was stinging, there was pain, and I don't...
Baking soda by John Weichner.
John Wexner.
A genius. Application by Paul Vacodia.
By the way, I'd like to take an aside right now and thank John for those flowers last week.
I didn't quite get it.
You're a sweetheart, John.
Wait a minute.
And I think that he's not interested in Greg.
And then before this, you burned yourself.
I was ironing, trying to get here.
Let's see that, boo-boo.
Here's the stove burn.
Ow!
Kevin, do you think about putting some baking soda on this?
Ow! Wait.
Not while I was... Well, now I was ironing, it wouldn't have done much good.
So you rock to live, don't you? You're dying, you're killing yourself to live.
Ooh.
Well, you know what, though?
The duality.
He's killing himself to live.
The duality of that statement is bullshit.
think of this.
Really something, Greg. It's
bullshit.
Moving.
Think of this, Kevin. That poor bee sacrificed its life so it could sting you. So you should be honored.
Sting.
Oh, yeah, I'm touched beyond
and
words.
Think about it. When you go home, you can think about
honor.
Sting, you know, from the police. Every breath you take, every move you make.
I could.
I'll be watching you.
And you won't.
I'll be watching you.
Oh, you won't. Anyway, so John Weichner's flipping through the channels this week, and he sees these people, the mind-altering alteration kids of the millennium, doing a parody of our show here.
We're being mocked.
And we haven't seen this yet, so we're gonna flip it on here. We're going to go to clip first, and then we're going to show it, and... You know, it's a parody of us. We haven't seen it to be a fresh reaction.
So we could be
and a fresh reaction from you, Kevin J. Hosey. And I want a letter grade on this, buddy.
Okay. So
this is somebody else's parody of us. I'm afraid.
I got the clap, Richard.
I'm a little afraid.
We're on. Okay. Well, I thought we were going to show the clip, though.
Where the true pain and the hunger of the true artists.
Shut up, what's wrong with that Michelangelo? That 15
I knew you'd be laughing a lot.
That thing.
You got my nose picking. I only did that
what
one.
What do you think, Gwen?
I really want to.
Yeah.
I really want to drive a Volkswagen.
Oh, shut up, no, you little tramp.
Somebody like reached puberty vocally or something?
No. I don't know about that, Fred. What about me? Look at over here spinning like a little freaking spin hopper traitor. So what's going on with you, Fred?
Well, I've been working at the Texas House over there in Elmwood while my painting career
Go take that camera off me.
Amazing.
You do that.
Wacky stuff, man. This is the coolest thing.
Greg is so good.
Hey, maybe a big
one. When we go.
I get one of these.
I'm a high player.
How about that?
I'm going to give you a punch.
How about that Rob Weiss? She's quite an actress, huh, Fred?
Oh, yeah. I was deeply moved by the poetry book that I was reading. I love to read quite a bit. You know, it did a lot of me a lot of time when I was working overnight at the Texas hot there. And I was reading a couple of books by Barry Stein and...
I think they got me down perfectly.
Like
that
me,
is exactly what I do.
That was just like
especially
me.
The spinning part. I like that.
Wow, what do you think of that, Kevin? You're the rock critic. You give it an A, a B, a C, a D, an E, an F?
B-minus. It was funny, but then the same joke about 20, 25
times. Yeah, it was a little too redundant. Yeah.
Just
no, we don't do the same joke.
We do the same thing over and over and over and over.
Yeah, but you don't know what's coming.
Till death. Oh, we don't? I'm going to do a song.
No, I'm sure. I hope you don't. If this is scripted.
Yeah.
No, it's not.
Good point, man. Good point.
But
do you remember your dreams?
Why are we discussing dreams?
I remember your dreams.
I had a dream today. Oh, do you want to hear about my dream?
No, not really, Gwen.
Okay.
Kevin, do you remember your dreams, man? Because, you know, I'm thinking that you probably have some like deep philosophical type dreams.
That's funny. Okay. I was discussing this topic with somebody very recently.
Who was it? Was it Giorgio?
I don't know any. Fortunately, I know no one named Giorgio.
Was it Link? Was it Big Todd? Anyway, so
Big
yeah,
Head Todd.
It was
maybe.
Big Head Todd. So anyway, so you discussed your dreams. You can't talk about it with me though.
I dream.
And Guinevere.
I didn't say that.
Oh.
I didn't say anything because you wouldn't let me.
Yeah, I'm ready. I'm ready though. Go ahead.
I dream about being chased or pursued and escaping.
Broads.
You
let them catch you.
Well,
you?
If I was being the pursuit by females would be a dream at this stage. No, it's usually
give them a hug.
Police or
give them a sexy hug. A sexy hug. Come on, it's worth it, baby.
Oh,
work
that's
it.
Different.
That's a lot sexier.
Isn't that nice? What are you, Mike?
Just shoot me from the waist up.
I'm not going to say it. What are you?
I am your pimp.
You are not.
And I also dream about here's a stretch being a reporter covering stories on Deadline.
Wow.
Yeah, I really fantasize a lot.
On Dateline?
Do you really do that in real life? Do you really cover stories on a Deadline?
Yeah, yeah.
Like what, for the B?
Yeah.
So like the hot breaking stories about the fence going down?
I was fortunate or unfortunate enough to have to cover many of the abortion protests and the press conferences.
Did you get shot at all? Shot at?
That's actually what this is.
You're saying it's a bee sting.
While the investigation continues, it's a bee sting.
Really?
Oh, okay.
Which side shot you?
The left.
The left. Which side would that be?
I don't.
That's pro-choice, the left?
No, we don't know. We don't have a suspect.
Oh, you mean like the literal side?
No, I didn't mean that.
Oh.
We don't have a suspect yet?
Do we have a suspect yet in the shooting?
No, we don't.
Who shot Kevin J? KJ.
Shot Kevin J?
Who shot KJ?
The suspect, I suspect that it could be...
Me?
You think it was me?
You know, Kevin, he's always talking about...
Well, he did
people
say...
People I want to kill in the media.
I heard him say on a show that he'd want me to die.
I was just joking when I said that, though. Remember how after that I said...
After you said it several times, then you said, I'm just joking.
I was joking, though.
But he says
time.
He wants to kill me.
My knee was sore with all the slapping from the humor.
You were doing this.
Oh, it was beautiful.
Good.
Don't forget that I do this whole show just for you. Every week, I'm doing it for you. In my brain, I'm thinking, Kevin Hosey's watching. Remember I told you that before?
Yes, you did. You scared me then also.
You know that guy outside your house? That's me.
That's
correct. When you go home to North Buffalo, there's that guy outside your house with a tarmac. That's me.
Wait, there was someone by the garbage last night.
That was me.
That was Greg.
Mr. Garbage, you know that.
I told you there were no crusts in the pizza box.
Oh, he likes to search through people's garbage.
Yeah.
Because the
landlord keeps wondering why the box is a pizza strewn on the lawn.
He's actually doing research for when he gives Rick Schiavone the CIA. He's doing the garbage searching.
Yeah, so the dreams are like men with knives coming at
what
you or
segue.
Guns? I'm just forgetting what Gwen said, whatever it was.
He's ignoring
me.
Just found that off ramp.
It was like men.
It's like armed people.
That's what I thought. Armed people with guns then. Or
yes,
knives.
Yes, with guns.
I had a dream that Charles Manson was coming to this house and he was chasing me into the house and he had a big knife, you know? And then I went in the house and I saw him downstairs right in front of the door with a big, big knife. And then I ran out of the house and there was a woods there. And I ran into the woods and he chased me. And he chased me. And he chased me. And he started stabbing me.
Did he say anything?
He said, why don't we do it in the road? Why don't we do it? Have you ever done it in the road, Kevin?
I'll pull Clinton to find it.
Why don't we
have you ever
do it in the road?
Had sexual intercourse with a woman in the road?
In a vehicle, outside a vehicle.
You ever had sex in a
right
vehicle,
on the tarmac on the concrete?
Yeah, on the tarmac, yeah.
No.
On the concrete.
No, I've never
like on a throughway.
No.
All the cars just coming towards you, and any second you can die or get hurt.
No, the closest was a vehicle. Never on the concrete.
So you made love in a vehicle
built
for driving in?
Have you ever done that, Greg?
You made love in a vehicle built for driving in.
Yes.
You made love in a vehicle built for losing it. Really?
Was
it a pink Cadillac?
Was it a pink Cadillac? Yeah, good question, Graham.
No, it wasn't a pink Cadillac.
You ever hear that song, Pink Cadillac?
Yes.
It's about sodomy,
too many times.
Sodomy, right? It's about sodomy,
don't
you think?
I didn't.
There are inferences to sex.
Yeah, sodomy, right? Because he says in the back.
Oh, here you go. Here you go.
Right? You know what I'm saying?
That can be inferred.
Well, have you ever had sodomy in a car built for driving in on the road?
Greg, where is this going?
This is going nowhere.
It's going down.
Did you ever have sex with Colonel Mustard?
Hey!
And then the library of the candlestick?
Did
you? Hey!
No, Colonel Mustard always...
They're dancing. Oh, yeah, they're doing a total... Yeah, they're dancing.
Yeah,
they're dancing.
Clue's a fun game, isn't it? I enjoy that game.
I like
Clue. Have you ever
played Shoots and Ladders?
No, I didn't see the movie.
Shoots and Ladders?
Now, there are some sexual innuendos playing Shoots and Ladders.
Whenever I play Shoots and Ladders, I think of Gwen. Sorry.
Dare we press forth on that?
Yes, dare we press forth.
Let's go on to a new topic. How about Monopoly?
Monopoly's also good, because it's all about cash. What's more important than cash?
In the United States?
I hope something, because I don't have much.
How much money do you have, Kevin? On you right now.
You
got like $18, something like that?
Oh, a little more than that. I got
26.
Paid today.
He's got like $22 in a Deer Park water.
A little less than that.
Okay, so it's in the... So are you going to go out and party and get drunk all night? Do you ever party night?
I don't drink anymore. I can't.
Oh, that's right.
Remember?
So I'm sorry. Yeah, you got the...
Thank you for bringing it up, Greg.
You look thinner.
It just came slipping out of me, man.
Mm-hmm.
I just figured a regular...
That's why we got the water here.
Yeah,
a little bit.
So that must... But in a way, it must feel good because you can always just... be spiritual.
It's easier to wake up in the morning.
Yeah, it's easier to wake up.
And you smell a lot better.
Because
I can't smoke either.
You can't
smoke.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, you don't smoke at all anymore
either?
I feel
bad now. I didn't mean to bring
that up. Do you feel better about that too?
No, it doesn't bother me.
I didn't mean to bring that up.
Do you feel better though?
It was a
fluke.
There was no choice. So
when
I guess I feel better.
When I quit smoking, I felt crappy for 4 months, and then I felt great.
Go ahead, phone caller.
Hey, how's it going?
Good. We got Kevin J. Hosey, our superstar.
What's that?
We got Kevin J. Hosey, superstar here.
Huh?
Go ahead, caller.
Oh, hey, Kevin. How's it going, man?
I'm fine.
Got a question for Kevin?
Yeah. I got a question for Kevin.
And the question is?
The question is?
Why doesn't the number 2 bus run more frequently?
I always wonder.
Actually, I think the number 2 bus probably drives, because if the bus ran, it would just be as bad as walking yourself, so there'd be no need to take the bus.
What are you, Clip Smith?
No.
Sorry.
He hates him.
I came here with a burn on my arm, stupid bee sting in my leg,
and now you're comparing him.
The only similarity is we both play tuba, and that's no joke.
Is this the Clipper on the phone? Go ahead.
Hey, Greg, I would have made it to the show, but,
Yeah.
Yeah, what you didn't.
Paul.
Well, you didn't, though.
Mass transit only goes up and down Main Street.
So you only go from downtown to UV, from UV to downtown, or UV to... I understand.
Once you get to Cheektowaga, you can go to anywhere in the world.
Okay, thank you for
calling.
Once
you get to Cheektowaga.
Thank you for calling.
Wow.
Clip. What, hang up
that was almost profound.
I have to. We're running out of time. We gotta do
bye-bye.
That.
Yeah, Cheektowaga, yeah. Gateway to Lackawanna.
I don't know what you guys are doing tonight, but...
No, you're probably...
I'm already on? Yeah. Kevin, when will all these clouds disappear? Kevin, don't you weep, all your kisses still taste sweet. I hate that sadness in your eyes. Well, Kevin, you can't say we never tried. With no money in our coats, like you mentioned earlier, and no loving in our souls. You can't say we're satisfied.
Nope.
But Kevin, I still love you, baby. Every time I see you, I think of your thighs. There ain't a woman who comes close to you.
That's for sure.
Come on, baby, dry your eyes. Oh, Kevin, you can't say we never... Try, Kevin, don't you weep, all your kisses still taste sweet. I hate that madness in your eyes. But Kevin, oh yeah, I still love you, baby. Always thinking about your thighs. There ain't a woman who comes close to you. Come on, baby! Why those eyes?
I moved like a bowel.
Clip.